Welcome, folks, to more Doom. The Hell Portal is now open back on Mars. Lost in the Hell Dimension, you are unable to stop the demons from absorbing our world. Kill every fucking thing you see and find a way back to Mars. Into the fire, baby.
Set up a portal device at the tomb. Use the light poles to mark our path.
I got a light post to mark your path. My dip! I am trying to work on getting Bandicam to record at 50 frames per second. Or 60 frames per second. In 1080p for you lovely hordlings. I'm gonna say, dude, if you die already, you got issues. On this level, we need to earn 4 Praetor tokens, kill 10 demons, and perform 4 leg sweeps. No idea how to do any of that. Well, the leg sweeps, anyways. Earning the 4 Praetor tokens, we'll just be getting the 4 League Guards. That's no biggie. Also, go ahead and purchase this for our micro missiles. Need to stick 4 different demons in 5 seconds. That is going to be harder than it sounds. And we have the Mancubus. He's a sweet motherfucker. The Mancubus is a lumbering behemoth demon. A foul odor accompanies its presence, and a stench that can be overwhelming if inhaled directly. Mancubi gorge on anything they can find and are not averse to eating rancid flesh. Their diet rots in their digestive system, making their innards highly flammable. These foul creatures are decked in light armor when they reach maturity, but their grotesque frame soon outgrows the armor, exposing their stomach and face. That would be 3. It's gonna be hard to get 4. I don't know what the fuck he's firing at. He's off his rocker. He's lost his shit. First secret up here, and some armor to go with it. Oh, you got fucked up, big guy. I'll rip this off, and you will blow the fuck up. Get that heated core while I'm there. Hello. Let her rip. Knee to the fucking jaw. Grab his, maybe he got to sweep the leg from behind, I don't know. I don't know, Johnny. I'm not the fucking Karate Kid. As I said, I cannot guarantee challenges, only secrets. Absolutely loving this game, by the way. I mean, it's a great throwback to the originals. This is how re-envisioning should be. To all you game designers out there, not changing things that make the original fun, just making them better in ways. Obviously, you can't grasp the perfect nostalgia without the nostalgia itself, meaning outdated graphics and outdated music and things that people like me and Drain and Gutter 7 and Mr. Satan and all the rest of you amazing hoardlings, things that we still hold dear, which is why we watch the game Hoarder in the first fucking place, because we don't mind a little sassy language and we love our fucking roots. One of the Praetors. Now, I actually was recording this part earlier and it fucked up because I left the room while the demon was talking, and this demon's voice is legit. So he's actually reading the log entry.
In the first battle, when the shadows first lengthened, one stood burned by the embers of Armageddon, his soul blistered by the fires of hell. Tainted beyond ascension, he chose the path of perpetual torment. In his ravenous hatred, he found no peace, and with boiling blood, he scoured the umbral plains, seeking vengeance against the Dark Lords who had wronged him. He wore the crown of the Night Sentinels, and those that tasted the bite of his sword named him the Doomslayer.
Alright. Sorry about that. Had to run and grab a drink while Mr. Demon Face was chatting. Anyways, he just reads the entry. Oh, we got three? What we got here? Ah! The Gauss Cannon. Yeah. That's a bad boy. Longer power-ups. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Alright, we maxed power-up effectiveness and equipment system. Probably do environmental resistance next. I don't really care about switching. I mean, yeah. I can see where that's somewhat useful. But anyways. That's the Slayer's Testament that Mr. Demon Lord read to us. Oh, smoking! You are smoking! Smoking again! That was a pretty good shot, actually. Fuck you. One of these bitches. Staying on top of that hooker. Where is that pirate hooker? My fucking arm now. Booyah! Kinds of little nooks and crannies to explore. Holy shit, all right. Turn it into a platformer. Luckily, he kind of grabs the ledge himself. You just need to smash into it. It's not very hard. Smoking! Ah, man, I could've... Oh, yeah. No! Son of a bitch! I was gonna try to get my micro-missile mastery. And I threw a fucking grenade! Oh well, here's a secret, folks. This little pecker wrecker. Blue skull key acquired there. Got it! Bottomless missiles, man. Oh, that's gonna make that gun pretty fucking diesel. Yes. Who the fuck? What'd you get, dickface? Cow demons! I gotta fucking do one! Rip your fucking neck! Mancubus! Hit him a couple times with the gauze. In trouble. I'm in big fucking trouble. I need, motherfucking help. Shit, that's back in the beginning. Damn. He smoldered me. Well, let's be honest. It wouldn't be too fun if I didn't get my ass handed to me once in a while. Awesome. Probably my new favorite demon in this game, the Cacao Demon. He's looking fucking rad. And of course they had to bring back these OGs. I was gonna say, if that motherfucker's still alive, he is resilient. I got fucking no time for this shit! I also have unlimited micro missiles now, just so you know. Warning you. Got micro missiles too, big guy. I'll take that. Oh, now you're gonna give me the fucking quad damage. Now Ron finds the. All right. Find that quad damage last minute, dude. Holy fuck. You make that any harder on yourself? Terrible. Survey the land. Rune trial. Kill him with super shotgun to allow movement for 4 seconds. Imps may be killed or spared at your discretion. Reach the altar before timer expires. Okay. I feel like they're getting into the puzzly type tricky things now. I don't know. that was fucking easy. That was probably the easiest one yet. Just smoke bitches and run. That's what I do. Get back to Mars. Savagery. I am savage as fuck. See shotgun shells. Can't be passing up those. Sounded like a yes. Urgent energy. Getter 7 recommended we focus on ammo instead of shields, so maybe I'll grab a little bit of both. But let's go ahead and pick up our ammo. So we can hold more ammo. That's good. Did that just fill everything too? Oh. Well, shit. No one told me that little piece of the puzzle. I'll take that, and you can fucking eat it! Awesome death sequence, by the way. Invulnerability. We like invulnerability. Please tell me I get to keep that. Fuck yes. Motherfucking chain gun, dude. Chain guns make me happy. Getting close to our rune power-ups. The Delta 12 chain gun, often referred to as D-12, is a high-velocity, heavy weapon capable of suppressing multiple targets at once. Recent changes to the firing mechanism have pushed the Delta 12 to the physical limits of a ballistic weapon. An argent-infused piston compresses gas with a firing crucible to over 220,000 PS motherfucking high. When released, this launches a 15mm tungsten slug with a muzzle velocity of nearly 5,000 fucking feet per second! The heat generated by this action is siphoned into a thermal gel compound that automatically recharges the 96-volt battery pack. I got one of those in my vibrator. Wait, what? This allows the weapon to sustain an almost endless firing cycle as long as ammunition is present. The Delta 12 chain gun weighs 45 kilograms. Making it lethal, but cumbersome. Hey, sounds a lot like my dick. You know what I'm saying? Just kidding. Ooh, the Kako Demon. Or as the game order frequently refers to as the Kakao Demon. There's a lot of silent syllables somewhere in there, consonants, or whatever the fuck they're called. Cocoa Puffs, are monstrous psionic demons driven by the desire to feed. They display limited intelligence, but are often sent into the fray as their natural size and abilities makes them an intimidating weapon for the demon horde. I fucking love them. This game is just getting better and fucking better. Invulnerability. When absorbed, the stimulant diffuses argent plasma to the basal layer below the dermis, creating a tough film bioplasma beneath the skin that protects the user from external attacks. This can make the demon almost entirely invulnerable until the plasma has been dissipated throughout repeated punishment. The bioplasma comes into direct contact with the nerve cells beneath the skin, which causes excruciating pain throughout the process. This increases the likelihood that, in the throes of agonizing torment, the mindless demon will try to attack targets that are clearly beyond their ability. Alright. Perform glory kills faster. Perform 25 unique glory kills. Okay, well. I don't know. I don't know what happens when you upgrade these fucking things either, so. The fact that I can carry the chain gun and climb ledges is impressive. Whoa! Flaming skulls and shit, dude! Awesome how it takes time to wind up. We obviously need some mods for it, though. Trying that shit with me, dude. I'll be taking that, Brander. You have no need for it. What the fuck? Rip your goddamn eye out for attacking me that close. Man, what the fuck? That is cheap as shit, dude. You! Game Warden does not approve of bum rush tactics unless it is in his favor. You microscopic pube. Two more elite guards, one more rune trial, two secrets. I don't know about that sweep the leg, and hey, I fucked up the 10 demons thing too. I'd like to get to that platform without dying. No shortage of enemies. Oh, there's a sweet delay. Hellraisers, I've been trying to do it on fucking imps this whole time. Damn it, wish I'd known that. I don't know what I was thinking. Okay, well, my momentum's over. Got a couple kills out of that. And one dead fucking mancubus. Who I dubbed the mancubus. The Bloodkeep, also referred to as Kanigar Sanctum, is a sprawling network of tunnels, catacombs, and temples that connected the wasteland umbral plains to the Great Steppe. It is believed that this area serves as a place of worship and vilification, as both hero and enemy can be found buried in tombs throughout the region. The area inhabited by all manners of demons, including the possessed, the unwilling, lost souls, hell knights, and other non-classified creatures. The Project Lazarus manned expedition, MTC 2145-128, uncovered one tomb of particular interest. The temple was adorned by powerful holding runes and unique relics. Despite the complete loss of human life on the expedition, the relics were successfully returned by scout bots to Lazarus Labs for processing and study. Unfortunately, records disappeared after the relics were sent to the Lazarus Labs, and they are now presumed lost. That's always good, you know, losing shit. let's grab some hazard protection. Hell, you never know. We got four here, but obviously, I'm trying to save it, because we also got a chain gun, you know, chain guns and shit, okay? My auto map is decked out. Use heavy assault rifle to weaken and perform death from above glory kills on three Hell Knights before time expires. This sounds a little bit more challenging. Oh, goodness. I'm not even going to deal with that one. That is going to take multiple tries, probably. And I'd rather keep the game flowing. Can always go back and do these later in the mission. You can earn the runes later after the mission's completed. The other thing to note is you still get credit for finding it. You can go back and do the trials later. Not really something I care too much about on this episode or this let's play. If I think I can do it and it's relatively easy, then I will, but if I don't even get fucking close, fuck it. That would probably take me a good 10 tries. And I have to work soon, and I want to get this video uploaded for you guys. Another secret up here. Pretty easy one to find if you do some jumping. This fucking retard grabs the ledge. One more secret, one more field drone, and two guards. That's fucking dope. Look at that skull. Oh, here's a field drone. Siege mode. Hold the weapon mod to transform weapon barrels into a mobile turret. High damage shot, like a super... That's pretty good. That sounds pretty awesome. What's siege mode? Oh, just like blast through all of them. Oh no, the sniper one sounds pretty dope. Help in the beginning of combat. I mean, we're gonna get them all eventually. We'll go with that. Shit, yeah. The data log. Doom Marine. Without doubt, the UAC's most remarkable recent discovery was undiscovered in the expedition to Hell's Candirum State Sanctum. After several kilometers through nearly impassable terrain, the team discovered a sealed tomb, its entrance and walls covered in protective runes and imprisonment incantations. Once opened, the tomb revealed many artifacts, including the Praetor suit. Most notable, however, was an enormous sarcophagus bound to the center bedrock of the tomb with thick iron bands, seemingly anchored to prevent anything from getting in or out. It was initially believed the sarcophagus must hold a rare, powerful demon, but when later opened, it revealed the body of a man. The body was not petrified or decomposed. In fact, he appeared to be the only sleeping, despite the fact the bed he lay in sleep seemed a millennia old. Attempts to wake the man were fruitless, and to harm him even more so, as a protective agent barrier around the body kept him safe from harm and permanent stasis. UAC archivist cataloged the discovery DM 1 through 5, but project personnel had soon dumped him the Doom Marine. While the history of this man remains conjecture, the Helix Stone, as well as other artifacts found at the Argent Fracture and during the Hell Expedition of ECM-13, have shed some light on his identity. An etching in the Book of Deva, another discovery of the Kandinger Expedition, depicts the Doom Marine wearing Praetor suit, engaging demons in battle as a hooded figure looks on. This image has previously observed numerous times in other artifacts, but only with the actual discovery of the Doom Marine and Praetor suit in the sealed Kadinger tomb have researchers begun to put pieces together. It is not believed the Doom Marine might have been part of an ancient group. Ancient group or tribe, maybe even their leader. Whether he is god, demon, or human will remain undetermined until the Argent barrier protecting his body can be deactivated, further deepening the mystery of his origin. UAC remote monitoring drones in the service during the Kadinger expedition recorded a protracted and deadly battle during the sarcophagus extraction. The demons attempting to defend the tomb with an instinctual ferocity previously unobserved. Once tethered and returned to the UAC, the sarcophagus was studied and first opened at the Lazarus Labs, but went missing a few weeks later. It's believed that Samuel Hayden had the body and praetor suit removed and hidden to keep it secure, although why he considered it to be under threat is not known. A final note to date, the Doom Marine and Samuel Hayden are the only known non-demon entities to successfully cross over from the Hell Dimension to our own, despite several attempts by their UAC human personnel to do the same. We have the Lost Souls, the Flaming Skulls. These demons are found wandering aimlessly within the temples of Hell as they search for hosts to inhabit. When a potential victim is found, they converge on the target and explode with a blast of Hell energy. Lesser-willed beings weakened by the explosion will be turned and possessed by the demon, and the host's soul becomes lost in turn. Tablets retrieved from the Koroks suggest the Lost Souls are considered the lowest of demons, even lower than imps, since the wandering nomads doomed to forever roam the halls of Hell thrive on the weakest entities. Lost souls are despised by other demons, despite their lowly status. They should not be underestimated. And the Gauss Cannon Mod. The accelerator designed by the UAC is the basis for numerous industrial projects over the years, such as the Argent Tower itself and the ore diggers found on Deimos and Phobos. With very few moving parts, the Gauss Cannon makes a reliable, powerful weapon. By accelerating steel fletchettes through a magnetized chamber, extremely high velocities can be achieved. The weapon has near-perfect accuracy thanks to the aerodynamic designs of the projectiles. Ammunition is cheap and readily available. Oh, here's my precision bow. This is what I actually needed to read. A standard telescopic sight can be placed in the Gauss Cannon, allowing for even greater accuracy at long ranges with this precise weapon. While using the scope, the operator can accumulate additional magnetic charge with the launch chamber, which when released will fire the fletchets at even greater speed. When fully charged, the fletchets are almost unstoppable and will pass through multiple targets. Exactly. And now this is when you want to, you know, make it energy efficient. Oh, that's bad. Volatile discharge. I'm all about that. I wouldn't have fucked up that Hellraiser challenge because I would have been sweeping legs a lot more on them. Two more show up. I can get that. Though actually, all those challenges aren't that difficult now that I think about it. Should have grabbed the one I could grab with the quad damage. Fucked that up pretty good too. The data log. As Tier 2 Advocate, you have access to privileged information that will help you understand the UAC's mission and purpose, and how you fit into the near future. You will be privy to a deeper understanding of our symbiotic connection to Argent Plasma, and how to harnessing and using it more than just good fortune. It's good sense. You will also no doubt start discussing some of the more sensitive subject matters that we Tier 2 Advocates mull over. One conversation that is often heard around the Argent Tower is, what happened to Samuel Hayden? As you know, our vulnerable leader designed the original Argent Tower, and during its construction, his mortal body was consumed by a devastating cancer. Despite this, Samuel did not give up and used the power of the Argent energy to create a new, more powerful body for himself. Samuel was still Samuel. He became so much more. While it became disconcerting to see Samuel now, remembering that Samuel never gets sick, never tires, and is never afraid, and what do we have to think for that? Argent energy, of course. Do you want to be like Samuel? Set your sights on becoming a Tier 3 Advocate. Tier 3 is where the secret power within you is revealed.
Sought retribution in all quarters.
Thank you, Sir Demon. Like a stronger Baron of Hell? Oh yeah. That is a not fucking around demon. Oh shit. That's the real deal right there. Gotta get you! Oh snap, motherfucker! Oh, two of them. Let's see that again. Downtown Judy Brown. Who's ready for a classic Doom map? Game Hoarder is. Oh, there used to be lost souls around every corner here. Mega Health, a stimulant to the first and so far only successful fusion of UAC technology and arcane science behind Argen stimulants. When consumed, it bestows additional stamina and endurance on the user, effectively giving them more life. This effect is achieved first by vaporizing, then ionizing an adrenaline solution, which is injected into a demagnetized Argen stimulant. As the resulting concoction is extremely volatile, the product must be absorbed immediately to avoid combustion. Notable that the stimulant can be administered to humans successfully, although it does shorten overall lifespan significantly. attempts to administer the solution to demons has proved unsuccessful. The demon suffers agonizing death moments after ingestion. And the Baron of Hell is now in play. Highest demon among the Order of Hell Knights. They rarely leave Hell, and no Baron of Hell has yet been captured by any of the Tellarine operations. Details regarding their behavior and physiology are therefore limited. And that's the other Slayer's Testament, which he read to us. Thank you, Mr. Slayer. Okay, let's get the fuck out of here. Having flashbacks. Okay. That up a little bit.
What? Okay.
Nobody likes you, little lost soul motherfuckers. I had no idea they'd make him fight in this. That's pretty dope. Oh, I just helped him out. I mean, come on, that's fun. Blowing up Mancubi and fucking Revenants from a distance like that.
It don't get any better. It just don't do it.
Aw, you fucking gotta be kidding me, man. Not even going for that shit. Ah, dope-alicious. Mancubi have taken their disgusting physical fucking condition and turned it into a weapon. As they reach maturity, a chitinous growth beneath the starts to form over each hand, creating a hard shell barrel. As the flesh inside decomposes, a noxious effluvium, I've never even said that word, begins to leak from the barrel. The Mancubus can spew this discharge, from barrel over a remarkable distance. The volatile goo ignites under tremendous pressure, creating a highly effective biomechanical flamethrower. Well... Oh, and then speak of the fucking devil. No know what? I got this. I'll take that and you can have it back. Boom. It's pretty fun feeding people their own organs. Right on. Super cool how they fuck each other up now without having to actually have them shoot each other. I dig it. Another challenge completed. Last collectible for the level. Olivia Pierce is the head of biochemical research at the Argent facility. Educated at Stroudsboro with a first-class honor degree in biomechanics and genetics, she joined her former mentor Samuel Hayden Mars to head up the Lazarus Project. A few months after arriving at the Argent facility, Olivia was diagnosed with acute idiopathic scoliosis. The cause of the deformation is unknown. Given the option of being permanently in a wheelchair bound or undergoing an experimental augmentation procedure, Olivia chose the surgery. After several months in seclusion, Olivia reappeared on her feet with new titanium exoskeleton grafted into her spinal column. Although the exoskeleton allows Olivia to stand and move on her own, it causes her excruciating pain. Olivia refuses any pain management medication for fear it will cloud her mind. Bitch is nuts! So nuts. Well, we got everything. Except sweep the leg, which I should have totally had. Ugh, irritating. Irrifucking-tating. Decrease self-damage from weapons. Sure, why not? And, we want to purchase that. Even though I'm not big on the ability itself. 8 out of 30, need to definitely get on top of that. We got bottomless missiles, and we're getting close to mastery challenge on heated core. That's pretty cool. Multi-targeting, although... kind of hard to say. Well, finally, I see the quad damage for once. No! That was a Hellraiser. That didn't count as sweep the leg? Fuck. Us into a little fucking battle right here. My fucking god, there we go. Get the big daddy out. Trying to get another death out of that guy. That's it. Ah, didn't get that sweep the leg. That hurts, but thanks for watching, and we'll see you soon.